Hello students, so in the previous class we people have seen the Griffith experiment and the Avery's experiment, which is proving the DNA as the genetic material. So Griffith has taken the mouse and Avery has cultured in the in vitro condition, that is in the laboratory condition. Now in the today's class we are going to see the one more experiment which is proving the DNA as genetic material, that is called as Hershey and Chase experiment. Okay, we are going to see the Hershey and Chase experiment, which is proving the DNA as genetic material. Okay, now students, here what Hershey and Chase have done for their experiment is they have taken the bacteriophage. First of all, they have taken the bacteriophage. Now, what is the meaning of the bacteriophage? Bacteriophage means the virus which infects the bacteria. Or we can say bacteria is infected by the viruses. Okay. So, the bacteria which is infected by the virus, or the virus which infects the bacteria, it is called as what? Bacteriophage. Bacteria which is infected by the virus, or the virus which is infecting the bacteria, that particular process is called as what? Bacteriophage. Next one is, we are going to see the E. coli bacteria, that is Escherichia coli bacteria. That is Escherichia coli bacteria. Now what is this Escherichia coli bacteria or E. coli bacteria? It is the type of the bacteria which is used for the tissue culturing method, we will say. Or we can say this is the special type of bacteria where we are going to see the presence of special type of DNA. What we are going to see? The presence of special type of DNA, that is plasmid. So due to the presence of the special type of the DNA, this is used in the, where? In the biotechnology. Where it is used? It is used in the biotechnology. Okay. So here bacteriophage is nothing but the viruses which infects the bacteria is called as bacteriophage. And E. coli, it is nothing but the, it is the bacteria which is used commonly in the biotechnological techniques for the practicals and for the culturing or for the testing or for the multiplying of the medicines, that is the synthesis of the medicines is done by this using this E. coli bacteria because of the presence of the special type of structure called as plasmids. And also it is we are going to see that there is a presence of radioactive phosphorus. There is a presence of radioactive phosphorus. Okay, there is a presence of radioactive phosphorus. For their experiment, they have taken the radioactive phosphorus and also the radioactive sulfur. Okay, also the radioactive sulfur they have taken for their experiment. So radioactive phosphorus will say and radioactive sulfur will say. Okay, they have taken elements for the experiments. Okay, so here students, once again I'll repeat the class before starting the procedure. Okay, what that we are going to see in the today's class, we are going to see the DNA as genetic material. By which experiment? By the Hershey and Chase experiment we are going to see. So Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase are the scientists who has proved the DNA as genetic material in a different way, in a unique way. What Avery has done, Avery, McClure and McCarty, what they have done, they have proved the experiment, DNA as genetic material experiment, by continuing the Griffith's experiment. Okay, by continuing the Griffith's experiment. See, Griffith experiment, they have taken the Streptococcus pneumonia or Diplococcus pneumonia bacteria. What Avery has done, taking that bacteria only, they have continued in the laboratory condition. But the speciality or the uniqueness of this experiment is they have proved this in a separate way or in a unique way by taking all these materials. What are the materials here? Bacteriophage, we will say. Bacteriophage is nothing but, here students have to remember this definition. What is bacteriophage? That is the bacteria which is infected by the viruses, or the virus which is infecting the bacteria. You can define any way. Okay, so that is the bacteriophage. And E. coli is nothing but the Escherichia coli, we will say. What E. coli is? It is the Escherichia coli. And this E. coli bacteria is more used in the biotechnology, especially for in the pharmaceutical products, in the medicinal products, synthesis of medicinal products. These Escherichia coli bacteria are used a lot in the field of the biotechnology. And last year is they have used the radioactive phosphorus and the radioactive sulfur. Okay, so these are the materials what Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase has been utilized in the experiment called as DNA as genetic material. Now students, in this what we are going to see is, we are going to see the three steps. Okay, what we are going to see in this, we are going to see the three steps. Which is the first step here? That is the infection. Which is the first step here? Infection. The second step is blending, we will say. And the third step is centrifugation. Okay, infection, blending and the centrifugation. These are the three steps what we are going to see in the Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase experiment. What are the three steps here? Infection, blending and the centrifugation. Okay, now we are going to see that what exactly they wanted to prove. What exactly they wanted to prove, that we are going to see. Now students, they wanted to prove that the bacteriophage DNA is moving inside, or protein coat of the bacteriophage is moving inside. Okay, once again I'll repeat what they wanted to prove. They wanted to prove that whether the bacteriophage DNA is going inside the E. coli bacteria, or the protein coat of the bacteriophage is going inside the bacteria. They wanted to prove that one. Okay, now here you see, I'll draw the bacteriophage structure. See here, this is the bacteriophage, as you people have remembered the PUC first year structure. Okay, so this is the bacteriophage and this is the E. coli bacteria. Okay, this is the E. coli bacteria and here there is a presence of bacteriophage. Now this is called as protein coat. What do we call for this? It is called as what? Protein coat. And here there is a presence of the DNA. So this DNA is called as bacteriophage DNA. What do we call for this? It is called as bacteriophage DNA. Okay. Now scientists, what they wanted to prove, students? Here they wanted to prove that whether this DNA is moving inside the E. coli bacteria, or this protein coat is moving inside the E. coli bacteria. And after the movement, what they wanted to see? Which is growing inside the E. coli bacteria in the daughter cells? Okay, which element is coming in the E. coli bacteria in the daughter cells? Now to prove this one, they have taken the two products, that is the radioactive sulfur in one petri plate. Imagine that in this petri plate, in the culture media, there is a presence of radioactive phosphorus. Okay, in one culture media, there is a presence of radioactive phosphorus. In the other culture media, there is a presence of radioactive sulfur. In the other culture media, there is a presence of radioactive sulfur. So here, separately they have culture. Okay, bacteriophage, which is consisting the radioactive sulfur, they have cultured here. Okay, some of the bacteriophages are cultured in the radioactive phosphorus. Some of the bacteriophages are cultured in the phosphorus, and some of the bacteriophages are cultured in the, where? In the sulfur. Okay, like this. The bacteriophage, they are cultured in the sulfur, and some of the bacteriophages are cultured in the phosphorus. Now, here students, you see, after culturing these bacteriophages in the culture media, what they have done, that is, they have just mixed these products. How this they have mixed? Okay, before going to that, I'll tell you the steps. First step is infection, we will say. Okay, first step is infection. So this infection is nothing but tearing the cell wall of the bacteria. That means here the small nails will be there. Okay, here there is this presence of small nails to the tail fibers. So these tail fibers are going to be ruptured. Okay, these tail fibers are going to be ruptured, and this DNA is entering inside this bacteria. Okay, this is the bacteriophage DNA. This is the bacterial DNA. Okay, so this radioactive phosphorus bacteria and radioactive sulfur bacteriophages are mixed in the one process that is called as centrifugation. Okay, see here, centrifugation we will say. Or we can say they have cultured separately. Okay, they have cultured separately. Centrifugation means what? That is, before going to this in detail, just I'll tell you what is the meaning of centrifugation here. Centrifugation is a rotating machine where they are going to separate the solid and the liquid particles. Okay, so here what they have done, radioactive sulfur bacteriophages, radioactive sulfur phosphorus bacteriophages, they have taken and they have mixed in a particular centrifugation process, and in the test tube they have seen that the two products are going to be separated. It is the second step, centrifugation. Okay, so just I'll tell you it once again I'll tell you, please concentrate here. See, the first step is infection. Okay, infection means what? The bacteriophage is sitting on the bacteria and it is tearing the cell wall of the bacteria. Okay, then the bacteriophage DNA is entering inside the bacterial cell. E. coli bacteria will say. Bacteriophage DNA is entering inside the bacterial cell and the bacterial DNA. Okay, so this is called as what? Bacteriophage DNA. And this is called as bacterial DNA. Okay, so normally all of them know that when the bacteriophage DNA is mixing with the bacterial DNA, the products will be bacteriophages only. Okay, the products will be bacteriophages only. Why? Because this DNA, this bacteriophage DNA is mixing with the bacterial DNA. Okay, bacteriophage DNA, see, concentrate on my words, I'm going very slowly. Bacteriophage DNA is mixing with the bacterial DNA, and then the hereditary characters, that means the characters are transferred from one DNA to other DNA, and then there is an arising of the bacteriophages. And then what is the arrest? Bacteriophages as the daughter cells, all of them, that means the normal bacteriophage reproduction we will see in the process. Okay, but here they wanted to prove that whether the DNA is transferred or protein coat of the bacteriophage is transferred. For that experiment, they have cultured these bacteriophages in the different cultural media. Okay, see, when this is cultured in the radioactive phosphorus, okay, bacteriophage is cultured in the radioactive phosphorus. Okay, radioactive phosphorus, and some of the bacteriophages are cultured in the radioactive sulfur. Okay, then they have centrifuged it. One second step, centrifugation we will say. What is the second step here? Centrifugation, or we can say centrifugation. Okay, in this centrifugation what they will do, they will mix these products. Okay, in this centrifugation what they will do, they will mix these products. After mixing, the rotating machine will be there. Okay, so one it will separate the solid particle. Okay, it will separate the solid particle. One upper layer is liquid particle, we will see. Okay, so that is the work of the centrifugation. 1000 rotations per minute, if we set that centrifugation machine, what it will do? It will separate the solid pellet and the supernatant, what do we say? So here there is a presence of the pellet and here there is a presence of the supernatant. Okay, so supernatant and pellet are separated from each other in the test tube. After the separation, okay, after the separation, what we will do? We are going to see that once again the normal E. coli bacteria are taken. Once again, the normal E. coli bacteria are taken and blended. See, blending, the third step is blending, we will say. Okay, the third step is what? Blending. So, in the two E. coli bacteria, see, here one E. coli bacteria will be there. Okay, and here one E. coli bacteria will be there. So, here two E. coli bacteria we have taken. So, in one E. coli, we don't know which element is present in the pellet, which element is present in the supernatant, we don't know. But we are knowing that it is a supernatant and the pellet. Okay. So, in one E. coli bacteria, the pellet is taken and injected. Okay. Pellet is slowly separated. See, imagine that this is the test tube of the centrifugation. Till here there is a presence of supernatant and till here there is a presence of pellet. So, slowly the pellet is separated into the another test tube. Then injection is taken and the pellet is taken, and then that is the insertion of the pellet in the normal E. coli bacteria we have seen. We will do that one. Then, so wherever the sulfur is there protein, only protein coat is going to develop. Okay, see, in one E. coli bacteria, pellet is injected. In another E. coli bacteria, supernatant is injected. Okay, then we allow them it to clone. Okay, after the insertion of the pellet, after the insertion of the supernatant, we are allowing them to clone, we will say. That means multiplication, we will say. So, wherever the pellet is there, okay, wherever the pellet is there we are going to see the arising of the bacteriophages with the DNA. There we are going to see the arising of the bacteriophages with the DNA. Wherever the supernatant is there, only protein coats are going to be arise there. Okay, only protein coats are arise there. This is proving that the pellet is consisting of the phosphorus as the radioactive element. When there is a presence of the phosphorus as the radioactive element, here we can see the growth of the what? Bacteriophages with the DNA. Here we are going to see the growth of the bacteriophages with the DNA. Wherever there is a presence of the supernatant, only sulfur is grown. So that means wherever there is a presence of the sulfur, only protein coat is grown. And there no DNA we are going to see. So this is proving that DNA is the genetic material. Why only in the E. coli bacteria consisting of phosphorus is grown? Why? Because phosphorus is one of the chemical component of the DNA. Okay, phosphorus is one of the chemical component of the DNA. Since the phosphorus is one of the chemical component of the DNA, so wherever the chemical components are mixing with the another organism's DNA, then the character is transferred. And as in the daughter cells, we are going to see the products of the same thing. Okay, here it happening like that only. Understood. So this is proving that DNA will be acting as a genetic material. Once again, I'll tell you, please concentrate. Slowly I'll go. Just concentrate for the Hershey and Chase experiment. So Hershey and Chase experiment, they have proved this experiment. They have done this experiment to show the DNA as the genetic material by taking the bacteriophages. Bacteriophages are those, that is the bacteria which are infected by the viruses. Those bacteria which are infected by the viruses, they are called as what? Bacteriophages. And they have taken the E. coli bacteria also. E. coli bacteria are those bacteria which are used normally in the medicinal synthesis of medicinal products, in the pharmaceutical industries, in the biotechnology. Whereas apart from this, they have also used the radioactive sulfur and the radioactive phosphorus. Okay. Now, they have started by the infection. Okay. They wanted to say that, they wanted to see that whether the bacteriophage DNA is growing or it is mixing with the bacterial DNA, or they wanted to see that protein coat is mixing with the bacterial DNA. Accordingly, first they have grown these bacteriophages in the different culture media. Okay, some of the bacteriophages are grown in the radioactive phosphorus culture media, and some of the bacteriophages they have grown in the radioactive sulfur culture media. Then after that, they have just separated centrifuge, we will say. Centrifugation means what? That is, they have mixed with each other and they have settled the rotations, 1000 rotations per minute. Okay, then blending we will say. In the blending process, what is going to happen, students? After the separation of the pellet and the supernatant, these pellet and the supernatant, that is solid and the liquid, if in your language we will say solid and the liquid. So solid and the liquid components, when they are separated in a different test tube, in one E. coli bacteria, solid product is injected, small tiny particles will be there. In the another E. coli bacteria, liquid products will be injected. Okay, and after the injection, these E. coli bacteria are allowed to clone. Now, clone means what? Clone means here the daughter cells are genetically and morphologically similar to the parental cell. Already this definition you people have seen in the first topic, that is reproduction organisms. Okay, what is the meaning of clone here? That is, the daughter cells which are genetically and morphologically similar to the parental cell. So here, what next step we'll do in the blending? That is, we will grow these E. coli bacteria in the different culture media. After growing these bacteria in the culture media, we will observe that wherever the phosphorus content is there, there we are going to see the growth of the bacteriophage with the DNA. Hope so you are understanding my point. Why only phosphorus? Why? Because the phosphorus is one of the chemical component of the DNA. So this chemical component of the bacteriophage DNA is mixing with the bacterial DNA of E. coli, and then there is in the daughter cells we are going to see the growth of the bacteriophages. Whereas in the sulfur containing media, or we can say the sulfur containing E. coli bacteria, is not showing the growth of the DNA. Why? Because the sulfur is not the chemical component of the DNA, but it is the chemical component of the protein coat. So since the sulfur is the chemical component of the protein coat, we are going to see that only the protein coat is developed, not the DNA. So this is proving that DNA will be acting as a genetic material. So this is the last experiment of the search for genetic material concept, that is DNA as genetic material. Okay, hope so you have understood. So first experiment what we have seen, Frederick Griffith experiment we have seen. Second experiment what we have seen, Avery's, McCrary and McCarty's experiment we have seen. The third is Hershey and Chase experiment, which is proving the DNA as genetic material by taking all these elements and also the three steps, that is infection, centrifugation and the blending. Okay, now next what we are going to see is properties of the genetic material. Well students, I have told you the three experiments, that is Griffith and Hershey and Avery's. Now we will see the properties of the genetic material, which is very very important for the 3 marks or 2 marks. And whereas the Hershey Chase experiment or Griffith experiment and Avery's experiment, they are very important for 5 marks. All the three concepts are very important for 5 marks. Now this is very important for 3 marks. Please concentrate here. What should be the genetic properties of the genetic material? The very first property is it should be able to replicate. And what is the meaning of replication? Next is, now we are going to see next concept, that the process only, replication process only. But here I'll just tell you this small definition. Replication means the process of production of the daughter cell as that of the parental cell. Okay, that is the meaning of replication. That is to produce the identical copy. Identical copy means what? They should be like a parental cell. Okay, that is called as what? Replication. Okay, the process of formation of the daughter cells as that of the parental cell, that is called as what? Replication. Then, I hope so you have understood the first property. It should be able to replicate means what? That material, genetic material, should be able to produce its own copy. That is the meaning of the first statement. Okay, then second one. it should be chemically and structurally stable. Now students, if you remember the all previous classes, there continuously we used to say DNA, DNA, DNA. Is it not? So that DNA chemically, it is changing chemically? No, it is not changing. It is fixed. Only the three chemical components we are going to see. If you remember the structure of the DNA, or we can say chemical components of the DNA class, if you remember, only three chemical components we are going to see. That is the nitrogen base, pentose sugar, and the phosphate group. So these three chemicals are very much stable, and structurally they won't change. Structure of the DNA is very much constant. Why the structure of the DNA is very much constant, I have told you already. That is, the larger component, one larger component will be there, one smaller component will be there. That is, one larger component means another side, the smaller component. Here smaller component means here larger component. So in a zigzag manner, the larger and the smaller components are arranged there. That is, purines and the pyrimidines. That is why the chemical structure is stable. It won't change. Even in the RNA also, it won't change. Chemical structure is very much stable. Okay. So here, second statement says that it should be chemically and structurally stable. That means chemically it should be stable. Structurally it should be stable. As I have already told you that chemical components are three, that is nitrogen base, pentose sugar, and the phosphate group. Next, it should have the scope for changes that are essential for evolution. Now, here just evolution means what? Previous characters, okay? That means the hereditary characters which has been transferred from your grandparents to you people. That is the evolutionary characters. Now, for example, somebody has told you people that you are just like your grandfather, you look like your grandmother and all. That is called as evolutionary characters. That is, it should have that capacity to transfer the hereditary characters from one generation to the another generation. Okay, that is the third compulsory property. Okay, that is, it should have the scope for changes that are having essential for evolution. That means mutation, what do we say? Little mutation has to be occurred in the character, or the it should have stable, just transfer the hereditary character from one generation to the another generation. Next, last one. It should follow the Mendelian principle of inheritance. So students, I have told you already, apart from the complete molecular biology is based on the principle of inheritance and variation, that is the genetics, what do we say? Complete molecular biology is based on the genetics. So it should follow the genetics, the molecular biology, that is the DNA and RNA should follow the genetics process, that is the genes, what do we say? Gene is the basic unit of heredity. Okay, gene is what? It is the basic unit of heredity. So on that basis only we should see the structure and how the characters are transferred and how they are acting as the evolutionary characters. So these are the properties of the genetic material. So how many properties of the genetic material are there? Four properties of the genetic material are there. That is, the first character or the first property is it should be able to replicate. That means the replication process, the daughter cells should be similar to the parental cell. Then second character is it should be chemically and structurally stable. That means just now I have told you the DNA structure and also the chemical composition of the DNA. It should be stable, I have told you. Then the third point, it should have the scope for changes that are essential for evolution. That means the evolutionary characters has to be transferred from one generation to the another generation. Then it should follow the Mendelian principle of inheritance. I have told you that complete molecular biology should follow the genetics. Based, if you have the knowledge of the genetics, you people are going to understand the molecular biology concepts. Okay. So just this is the property of the genetic material, which is very important for 3 marks we have studied. So next is we are going to see the very, very important concept, that is called as what? Semi-conservative replication. That concept, it is very important. So before going to that concept in detail, we should have the basic knowledge of semi-conservative replication. Well students, that will continue in the in the next class. But today's class, what you have understood? Search for genetic material in that Hershey and Chase experiment. Also properties. Okay.